see me now. English dictionary in hand, trying to write you this letter, trying to understand this language better so we could communicate. You would never believe it. For 20 years, I've refused to learn this language, to immerse myself into this culture. I've gone to ESO lessons and sat defiant, applying henna to my hand, living in a dream that soon we'll go back to our land and this will all just be so far away. But now I fear the gap between us is too wide. When I speak to you in Somali and you reply in English, it's a reminder of how far apart we really are and how much the cultures that raised us have taken from us, how much I do not know of you and how much you do not know of me. I've watched you grow into a culture I do not know, a life I do not understand. I've walked you to schools and playgrounds, seen the joy in your face as you played ringa-ringa roses and smiled into the face of a woman as white as the sheets you slept on. I have known pain in this life, but I have never had my heart broken more than in that instance, as if whiter skin meant more warmth. I watched you reach for her and I spent my days muttering silent prayers, oh Allah, bring them back to me. You see, I have loved you, perhaps not how you think I should have done. Perhaps I should have spoiled you with toys, filled you full of sweets and let you run the streets, but I have loved you the only way I know how to, the only way I was taught, through prayers, tears and laughter as heavy as the rain of my once upon a time. I've laughed with you at how my R rolls too thick off my tongue and how my remember always sounds like remember, how I say Birkenham instead of Birmingham, and remember how you cried with me when fireworks on Guy Fawkes brought back the memories of how my Uncle Ali died, how I watched, how I heard the 15 shots, how I held him after when I prayed through ragged breaths, just let him breathe, let him breathe. I have cried for you the same way, afraid that every death reported while you were out after sunset is yours. I wish that I could make you understand. I'm afraid this land that kept you safe from mortars will kill you for your mobile phone. I've screamed through gunshots, shouted from rooftops and run with shrapnel in my spine, carrying you on my back to bring you here, England. This land that promised safety, this land that you call home. This place that taught you things I did not know and told you that I could never understand, as if what made sense to you can never make sense to me, as if we had never known our love back home. But you are proof that we loved in Somalia, that we danced and dreamed, that your father lay me on my back and we conspired to create you. But you feel less like mine and more like hers these days. London feeds you now and clothes you. I'm afraid that one of these days she will swallow you. Thank you. I just want to thank all of you guys for giving me these 4 months of your life, for coming in each week and letting me practice my crazy ideas on you guys. I made them sit on the floor, I made them answer really, really intrusive things, and I'm just so proud of you guys. Honestly, I'm crying. But I'm so proud of all of you, your performances, who you are, just everything. Thank you for giving me the privilege. Thank you.